For me, when I first read the script, I was thinking, oh, I'm not sure if I want to make this film, because I thought, oh, it's going to be difficult and harrowing and depressing. And when I read the script and I saw what an inspirational story was in it. And for me, what Jack had done, Jack the screenwriter had done that was so clever, was he made it a story about two sisters. So it was about the obvious hero in Yusra that I'd heard about and read about in the news, but there was also a second sister, and just as heroic, an unsung hero. And it was that sibling relationship. As a younger sister and an older sister, I really connected to that sibling relationship. So initially I wanted to cast Syrian actresses, and so we went down that route and we're looking for Syrian actresses within the diaspora, because they also had to be bilingual and be able to act in English and Arabic, and they also had to swim. So the Venn diagram got smaller and smaller, and then sadly the paperwork situation for a lot of the Syrian young women that were kind of made it through to later stages was very difficult, and they weren't going to be allowed to film in the countries we were filming in. So then we opened up the casting process to the Levant. I was very aware of Manal Issa. I'd seen some independent films, Lebanese independent films that she'd been in. And so when I auditioned her, she mentioned she had a little sister who was studying literature. And then I was very interested in her little sister coming and auditioning. And when they screen test, their chemistry was just amazing. And I knew that I'd found the sisters.
Obviously, this is a story that is very specific in some ways, but seems to speak very globally. Can you talk about the message of the film that you're hoping people most take away from it?
Yeah, I mean, for me, the inspiring thing about the story is how these young women became the heroes they became. You know, ironically, war turns everything on its head. And for young Arab women, you might not be allowed a degree of freedom that these young women, war allowed these young women to take their fate into their own hands and go on a journey unaccompanied in this manner. And I think that there's an ironic journey of liberation in the movie. An audience to feel like they were going on the journey with the characters. We get very used to and desensitized by the news images of refugees, and it's very easy to turn the channel. So on every level of the production, I was trying to allow an audience in to be on that journey with them, connecting with the sisters and feeling as they felt through it. That was a technical aspiration, but also a creative aspiration throughout the whole production. Yusra and Sara are very much the 1%, and in the movie I also wanted to honour the 99% who maybe don't have that inspirational ending, and that was through the cousin Nizar and his narrative. So I hope that through the movie you see the full range of the refugee experience. Yeah, I mean, filming during COVID was tricky, but so was filming in the sea for real with animals and children. All the things they tell you never to do were in the movie, and it being a road movie. So we were constantly on the move, constantly only in a location for one day. And it was a 3-month shoot. So it was a challenging shoot. I mean, the city is diverse and international as Toronto. It's just the perfect home for a movie like this. So I couldn't have dreamt of anything better.